Hi everyone and welcome back. This video is important. Here we are going to create a custom hook for making an API call. Like we can create use axios, use fetch, these kind of custom hooks. So in the previous video we created a use counter. We will modify this function. So here instead of this, what we will do is use axios. Okay, and we are going to accept a lot of arguments here. First of all, arguments will be the API, lot of arguments, so API methods, all these arguments we can take. API comma method name comma the URL, API URL, then we have a data. If you wanted to pass something in the body, by default that will be run null. Okay, we will be returning something from this hook and we will be doing something inside it. Okay, so what we will be doing, obviously we are going to make an API call. So we will be using use effect hook to make that API call. And what will be the dependency? Here the dependency will be whenever these things are getting changed, we will make an API call, API method URL data config. Okay, so there is one more argument we have, which is config. Sometimes we pass the config, which has all the header information and all. So these are the dependencies for our hook data config. Now this we have, okay, sorry, this should be a dependency. Now what we are going to do inside this, we are just going to write some async function. Okay, how we can call that? You can just call one method like get data, why this get data function we are calling, and this get data function we can define as an async function. Okay, so there are many ways of writing it. So here we have just created this. Now you can outside, you can actually create async function, and here you can do await stuff. Okay, or what you can do is simply create a this return another function from here, const fetch data. Here you can just assign this as async function, and what we are doing here is lot of calculation, and this fetch data you can call. Now this is just another way to write async await inside a use effect callback, use effect hook. Okay, so here we have to wrap it inside try catch because we are using async await. So inside catch, if we are getting any error, then we have to deal with this. Otherwise we have the finally block, try catch finally. Try catch should be fine. So in the try, we are going to make an API call. So if I just write the whole try catch block, how it look like is, it should be something like this. I'll just format this. Okay. So in the use axios, we are writing use effect, and it is just calling this fetch data async function. Okay, fetch data has async function, and this is returned, this is doing this API call and setting us the data. So we have few use state hook also, which are actually capturing the response from this API call, like response, set response, error, set error, loading, set loading. So once you are done with this API call, what we are going to return is the response, error, or is loading, because what I need is after passing the input, I just wanted to know what is the response, is what is the current state, either we got the error, we got the loading status, loading, loading false, did we get any error, or what is the response object. So while I will consume this, so I will just minimize it, try catch block, this is my hook look like. Okay, this hook is taking a lot of inputs and then it is returning these three things, response, error, and is loading. Now while writing this inside a component, it is going to be straightforward. Here we have, right, so what we can do is we are getting response and is loading from the use fetch, it is use axios, so we'll just import it like this. We are passing API method URL and config, same thing. We are passing some set of argument. This is HTTP get call, so you don't need a data, which is initialized with null. Once you this get executed, it is going to return a few things. Response is loading. So what I'm tracking only is response and is loading. You can also get error. if we are getting any error, then we can capture it. So now we are getting response, and in this component what we can do is we can track. If we are getting response which is not null, then do something. So we can use use effect. So we are getting response. If response not equal to null, it means we got the data, and we can actually set data here. This autofill is very annoying. Response not data, and here you can have a use state hook for data also inside this component. Like I have a data and set data, and this is initialized with empty array for now. You can call set data and you just set the response, right? So you can see how we are able to actually write our own custom hook, and we are able to consume it here. We are getting response is loading error. So similarly, you can write n number of these custom hooks, and you can just use them in your component. Let's see, we'll write one more custom hook and we'll see how it works. Thanks everyone.